First of all, I want to thank God for the privilege of being among a group of patriots like yourselves. It is an honor and a privilege. And what we are about, like the quote that you had earlier, what we are about is a new American revolution, a new American revival. And it doesn't take a whole lot of people to do that. My understanding is that those who participated in the original American Revolution were only about 3% of the population. It doesn't take a whole lot of people, but it takes some people who are committed and dedicated to changing things. As we were talking about the federal deficits and the expenditures and the cost of salaries for federal employees, I couldn't help but remember, in fact, I was talking to one of the other candidates about this, I couldn't help but remember I started my career as a federal employee. I went to work for the United States courts as a law clerk to United States District Judge in San Antonio, Texas for $26,500 a year. Now, if I had gone in the private sector at that time, I could have made between $37,000 and $55,000 a year. At that time, you sacrificed in order to get the experience working in the federal court, and then you went out and hopefully could get more money once you learned something. But today, the average federal employee makes $121,000 a year. The average private sector employee makes $60,000 a year. What's wrong with that picture? We need to reverse that, and we need to cut federal salaries. One of the first things Barack Obama did was raise federal salaries 30% across the board. He bribed every single federal employee in Washington. And they're pretty happy with Mr. Obama. Who wouldn't be? Now, if you happen to be the recipient of the 30% pay raise, I should say. Now, if you're paying for that 30% pay raise, it's another matter. I am in the Alamo District in San Antonio. And those of you who've studied the history of Texas, or maybe you haven't, and I'm getting in. I'm also a professor, guys. I was a professor for 17 years. So tell me to go 3 minutes is like, anyway. But in San Antonio, Texas, Mr. William Barrett Travis said, "I will not surrender or retreat, victory or death." That's how he signed his last letter out of the Alamo. But a lot of people don't understand that the Alamo was a battle for constitutional government. The flag of the Alamo had the letters 1824, the year 1824, on the banner. It was a quote-unquote Mexican flag. The colors were the Mexican flag colors, but 1824 was in the middle of it because that was the Constitution of 1824 for Mexico, which was patterned after the United States Constitution. And all the settlers had come down to Texas to participate in a constitutional government, a republic of Texas. Actually, it was Mexico, but a new constitution for Mexico. Now, there arose in the centralized government of Mexico City a new leader. His name was Santa Anna. Santa Anna was a charismatic man. And he decided that he was going to impose a European-style empire on Western United States and Western Mexico, most of the continent, if you will. He called himself the Napoleon of the West, and he proceeded to say, "Constitution? I don't need no stinking constitution." And he decided he was going to rule autocratically from Mexico. He threw Stephen F. Austin into jail when he went down to petition the government with redress of grievances. Now, but a few Texans drew a line in the sand. And they said, "No, you're not going to take constitutional government away from Texas." And they died in the Alamo defending constitutional government. And then they joined the United States because the United States had constitutional government. Now it's time for people in the United States, and I tell you, in Texas, we're going to do it. We're drawing a line in the sand again. And it's time that we stood up and had a United States flag that says 1776 in the middle of it, and that we are going to stand by that Constitution, even to the extent of losing our lives. Now, I've got so much to say, and I can't say it all. Charlie Gonzalez has voted 100% of the time with Nancy Pelosi. He's 100% for Planned Parenthood. He's 100% for abortion rights. He's 100% for partial birth abortion. He even voted against the Born Alive Infant Protection Act. He has voted for every single spending bill that's ever come down the pike in San Antonio, Texas. He's got an F rating with the NRA. I happen to be a member of the NRA. Everything that he has voted for, I stand against in my campaign. I got so much stuff here I can't cover it. I'm going to skip down. I'm just going to skip down. I agree with the things that have been said. I'm against cap and trade. I'm against amnesty. I'm against card check. I'm against card check off. I'm against universal health care. I am for liberty. Yeah. I am for liberty. And I taught international business law at Texas Tech University and at Trinity University in San Antonio for a total of 17 years. I've taught about the International Balance of Payments. I've taught about the World Bank. I've talked about the Bretton Woods Agreement. I've talked about and taught about all of the financial institutions, the international financial institutions that have governed the world, if you will, financially since the end of World War II. And what is going on now with our currency is unprecedented in the history of the world. Since 2008, January 2008, there has been an excess of tax revenues. The Congresses, by the way, it's Congress that passes budgets, not the president. Congresses have spent $4.1 trillion in excess of tax revenues. Tax revenues were $3.8 trillion and $4.4 trillion in those 2 years. So in the last two and a half years, they spent $12.5 trillion. That's roughly equivalent to the entire savings of the World War II generation in America. Folks, it's getting out of hand. That happens to be an amount equal to $20,000. I computed it out on a napkin for some young people the other night. $20,000 for every man, woman, and child in America. If there's four members of your family, it's $80,000. Your debt has gone up in just 2 years. And that's on top of the debt's already been there. Now listen, Charlie Gonzalez voted to increase the debt limit to $4.1 trillion next year. And they did that, though, by six votes. Six votes. All we need to do is replace seven congressmen. And as my daddy used to say, the first thing you do when you find yourself in the bottom of a pit is stop digging. Thank you very much.